Bonjour, tout le monde. I've had a day or so to check out Brilliant Diamond, and since I've been so hyped for this game this past month, I wanted to take a few minutes to share with you guys my early impressions. I specifically wanted to make it to Eterna City to unlock the Grand Underground, which was the new, or I guess I should say updated, feature I was most excited about, on account of it really opening up the Pokémon available to you earlier in the game in the same way that I've heard the Wild Area does for Sword and Shield. While I haven't gotten to play around much with the Underground yet, and the few wild battles I fought down there seemed a little overtuned for my current team, making it unfeasible to catch them, I'm looking forward to seeing what more there is in store in the near future. Supposedly, Swinub and Smoochum are potential spawns in the Underground as soon as you can access it, which would alleviate one of my biggest gripes about ice types in-game with them being locked to the second half of most games. But I'm getting ahead of myself a little here. I've been enjoying the game so far, and definitely appreciate the party-wide experience share for the ease with which it allows me to train multiple Pokémon at once. With me cycling between so many of them, I'm not overleveled at all, and in fact I've encountered some reasonably challenging battles even this early. The first fight against Mars, especially, comes with a surprise or two. It's sometimes been a nuisance that the game seemed to be using the Diamond and Pearl encounter tables as opposed to the expanded Platinum ones, but between the Grand Underground and the overall less annoying encounter rate, that's a sacrifice I'm willing to make. I will point out something that I wish had been mentioned by reviewers, that you don't start the game with the ability to access your box anywhere. You only acquire it after fighting Team Galactic in Jubilife City, which, while still reasonably early on, was a bit of an unwelcome surprise all the same. The game's visual style does take some getting used to, and while I've seen people compare it to the Switch remake of Link's Awakening, these games lack the hazy, dreamy quality that made the diorama look work for Zelda. Even so, it's a common observation that more stylized graphics tend to be more memorable and age better than realistic graphics. So in 5 years or so, I could see the fandom still bashing Sword and Shield for looking the way they do, while holding up Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl as quirky and cute. What about you? If you're playing Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, what do you think of them so far? Like, subscribe, and tell me about it in the comments. Au revoir!